Okay, so to start off with, you need to take off some of the casing from your washing line. So I'm going to use my wire strippers, and you want to take off about an inch. It's probably just a little less, but not to worry. Then if you measure about 2 inches from the tip, and you're going to want 4 of these. Next, take one of your pieces of washing line, one of your hooks, and one of your pieces of tape. Now all we're going to do is attach the washing line to the tape. Like so. And then we're going to join that to the hook. So this is a real Blue Peter moment. You just wind that round. As you can see, I've come a little way down the hook shank as well. And once you've done that, you can pull off the rest of this casing. Now you can see your feathers actually starting to take shape now. So do that with the other 3 as well. Now you have 4 feathers ready to be tied on. The actual hook lengths, I'm going to be using 30-pound line, and it's going to be about 60 centimetres long. This is where we find out how closely you were paying attention in the last video, because this is where we do the knotless knot. Run your line parallel with your hook shank down roughly where the bend of the hook is. Then just start wrapping your line. Back down the shank of your hook. Now in the video, I said to do about 10 wraps. With these, I like to go all the way down until all of the tape is covered. Like so. And we just come back up. 1, 2, then back through the hole. And pull that nice and tight. Now not only is that all held on with tape, it's also got a really strong knot holding it all together. Get your tag end. Snip that off nice and close. and away you go. So again, do that with all four. The main body of your rig, you're going to be using 60 pound mono, and you're going to measure off about 25 centimetres, 250 mil, and you're going to create a little double overhand knot. Like so. Pull that so it's not quite tight. And then measure off another 20 centimetres, 200 mil. And do another. And again. And last one. Like so. Now you're going to take your feather. Where you've made this double hand, double overhand knot, you're going to go up through one of the holes and then back down through the hole the other side. And if you pull this up so it's tight against the knot, just create a loop. Create a loop with the line that's on your feathers, and you're just going to do a grinner knot. So that's going to come back in and out three times. So one. And three. Just tease that up a little bit. Bit of saliva. And you can see that knot. Hold your main line and your feather. And just pull that down. And those two knots are going to butt up against each other. Once you've done that, trim off your tag ends, obviously making sure that you're trimming off the right one. And the next thing you want to do is at the top of your rig, I always put a swivel And just use your normal everyday knots for this. So I'm using a Tuck's blood knot. And on the other end, I'm using a breakaway fast clip and a swivel. And again, just use your favourite knot. Mine's Tuck Blood. Trim off your tag ends. And there you go.